That transition to digital television has been referred to as a really big do-it-yourself project. And so we're going to turn to some of the best do-it-yourselfers we know, the team from this old house. While Kevin and Norm check the houses in a Boston neighborhood, our volunteers will still be here to take your calls and answer your questions about digital TV. And stay tuned, because a little later, we will show you exactly how to connect up a digital converter box, how to set it up so you can get all the channels in your area.
Hi, I'm Kevin O'Connor. Welcome to a special program explaining the transition to digital television. For the past 30 years, a crew at This Old House has been helping homeowners solve problems and make changes around the house. And we could not have done it without our friends at PBS, the nation's public broadcasting service, which sends a television signal to audiences across America. Dramatic improvements in the way that television signal is sent are already underway. And to help us understand those changes, we have put together a team that includes special investigative reporter for the PBS News program Now, Maria Inahosa. Good morning, Maria.
Hey, Kevin. How you doing?
All right.
So here's what's going on. The way we've been watching television from the very beginning through analog transmission, that's changing. It's going to go away.
So analog transmission signals are going away, but networks and stations are already broadcasting digitally, but it's something they've been working on for many years.
For the past 10 years, they've been working on it. But right now, here's what's happening. Starting in February, everything will be digital television. But you know what, Kevin? Lots of people have questions. Even you and I who work in television, we have questions. This is a show that's going to answer those questions.
All right, well, let's get right to it.
Let's do it.
And there's the third member of our team, Norm Abram. Good morning, Norm.
Good morning, Kevin.
Hey,
hi,
Norm.
Maria.
How you doing, Norm?
Great. Now, I understand that you've done a lot of studying on this conversion to digital television and that you have a really good handle on it.
I'm trying to get a handle on it. You know what the thing is, Norm? A lot of people think this is really complicated. But when you break it down, it's not so hard. Some televisions receive over-the-air broadcast signals. They use a rooftop antenna or an indoor antenna. Those are sometimes called rabbit ears. Now, other televisions are connected to cable TV, and the signal is sent directly over a wire. Other TVs use a satellite dish to receive a signal that has been relayed from a satellite overhead. The important thing to know is that any TV that receives its signal from satellite or cable television is not going to be affected by the transition to digital television. But if you have an antenna, whether it's on your television inside your home or on the roof of your home, you're more than likely going to be impacted by this change.
All right, sounds simple enough. If you have an antenna, it means you're receiving it over the air and you're probably going to be impacted. But if you've got satellite or cable, nothing to worry about.
Well, except let's say you have satellite or cable in your kitchen and you forget that you have an antenna in your kids' rooms with their television. It means you have to think about these things. But ultimately, look, even if you understand it, it's good information to have, because that way you can help a neighbor or a family member who may need some help on this issue.
So exactly what will be changing?
Well, for the past 50 years, broadcasters have been using an analog transmission signal to send television. Most stations have already begun using both analog and digital television. But here's what matters. On February 17th, 2009, nearly all stations across the country are going to be required to turn off their analog signals.
So why do the stations have to turn off their analog signals?
Well, the federal government required that they do this because digital television has several advantages over analog. The new digital signal can carry more information than an analog signal, and this has a lot of benefits. With DTV, stations have the option to send multiple programs in the same DTV broadcast, so that creates many more program choices for viewers. Since most broadcasters are already sending digital signals, some viewers may have already noticed that these new program channels exist.
Well, I've already seen the changes. I'm getting more television stations on my TV at home.
That's right, and you're probably seeing better quality. You're probably also getting better sound quality. But there's another important advantage. When you free up broadcast spectrum, it means that now you can use that for first responders, public safety. It really is an important issue for us.
So what's going to happen when the analog signal is turned off? Is that the end of free over-the-air television?
No, it's not the end of free television, but there are a few steps that TV viewers may need to take if they want to continue to receive over-the-air television. For example, in this house, there are two television sets. Downstairs, there's a newer television with a built-in digital tuner that's connected to the roof antenna. Upstairs, there's an older TV that uses rabbit ears. As long as broadcasters send analog and digital transmissions, both televisions will continue to receive a signal. But in February 2009, when the analog signal is turned off, the older TV will probably not receive a signal.
And how do you make the older TV work then after February?
Well, probably the simplest way is to install a converter box and possibly a new antenna. The converter box will receive the digital signal from the antenna and decode it so that it'll play on any television.
So if a viewer has a newer television with a built-in digital tuner connected to an antenna, they won't have to do anything. They'll be able to receive over-the-air broadcast without making any changes.
So how do you know if the TV has a built-in digital tuner or not?
Right, so that's when you have to actually pull out your trusty owner's manual of your television and look for it there. Or you may need to look for the, on the television itself, and you'll be looking for a logo that says ATSC, or you can also look for one that says DTV Tuner. If you have an older television and you don't see these one of these two things, it means that if you don't prepare when the change happens, you will not receive a broadcast signal.
So if I buy a new TV, it'll definitely have a digital tuner.
Well, you can actually still be sold an older television. So you as a consumer, you have to make sure that it has one of these two logos, either one that says ATSC or one that says DTV Tuner. If you see one of those two things, you'll be okay.
But what if I don't want to buy a new TV? Is there any way that I can take my old TV and make it work somehow?
You know, Kevin, they thought about that, and this is what they came up with. You can buy a converter box, and this will convert the digital signal into an analog signal.
All right. So I still have to buy something, though. How do I get my hands on one of these?
You can either buy it on the web, or you can go to an electronics store. They cost anywhere from $40 to $80. You can apply for a limited number of these government-issued coupons. This one is for $40, and essentially this can help offset the costs.
All right, I like the sounds of that. So we've actually got to go out into a neighborhood, and we've got to help that neighborhood get ready for the switch to digital television. Before we go, let's make sure we got all our points right.
I think so.
All right, so we're only talking about people who are affected by over-the-air transmissions. If their TV is hooked up to a cable, we don't have to touch that TV. If their TV is receiving a signal from a satellite, we don't have to touch that TV either, right? Mm-hmm.
But if they get their over-the-air transmission to an old TV, we'll have to show them how to hook up one of these, the converter box.
Okay, and the household could also have a new TV with a built-in tuner, but whether they have the converter box or the built-in tuner, they still need an antenna, so we'll check on that as well. Sound good?
Sounds good.
All right, well, let's get to it, and we will report back.
We'll see you here.
All right.
We've got our work cut out for us. We've got an entire neighborhood to get ready for DTV.
Yep, we have a lot of folks to deal with, and they have a little bit of everything in this neighborhood.
I saw some houses with satellite dishes, others with those big old antennas.
Right, and a lot of people have cable running right into the house.
All right, a lot to do. What do you say, we split up?
All right, catch up with you later. Now, this house has an over-the-air antenna that's strapped to the chimney, and if we go along the ridge to the front of the house, there's a satellite dish. I wonder what's going on here. Hi, Susan.
Hi, Norm. I heard you were in the neighborhood.
Yeah, we're helping folks get ready for digital television. Have you heard much about it?
I have. I've heard that I'm going to need to buy a new TV by February of 2009.
Not necessarily. How many TVs do you have?
I have just one. Mm-hmm. It's right off the kitchen here.
So how many years have you lived here?
Since 1992, uh-huh. So 16.
Uh-huh. Now, I noticed that on the outside of your house, you have one of those old over-the-air antennas strapped to the chimney, yet at the front ridge, there's a satellite dish. So which one is this TV hooked up to?
Well, this TV is hooked up to the satellite dish. I got that a year ago, and nothing's hooked up to the antenna.
Okay, well, you know, that's great news, because the satellite company has already done the conversion, so you don't have to do anything.
Oh, great. So I'm going to get a high-def picture on this TV?
No, this is an old standard definition TV, so you won't get high definition. However, it's going to look exactly the same in February as it looks right now. So you're all set to go. Now, if you have any friends or relatives who are worried about this change, you might want to try to help them. And since we have absolutely nothing to do, we're all set.
Oh, well, Norm, I understand you're a handy guy, and I've got a few squeaky doors. Would you mind having a look?
Define few first.
Here's a house that has an antenna on the roof, which means that they are probably receiving their television signal over the air, and if that's the case, they're going to need some help.
Hey there, Fran.
Hey, Kevin, old boy. Hello, nice to see you. I'm glad you just dropped by. And I understand you're going to help me out with some sort of a problem here.
We're going to try. We want to make sure you keep getting your television.
Oh, great. I couldn't be without the television.
So I saw that you have an antenna on the roof. Is that how you're getting your signal? I see a cable coming in.
That's the way it is.
So this is connected to the roof antenna?
Yes, it is.
All right. So this is probably feeding the signal to this TV. Is that right?
This TV right here.
All right. Do you have any other TVs in the house?
I certainly do.
How many?
Three others besides this.
And are they getting a signal from the roof antenna?
No, they're not.
How are they getting
the rabbit is.
Ah, okay.
The rabbit.
So everything in the house is getting over-the-air signals. That means you are going to need some help.
Are you going to help me with it?
I hope so, because in February, if you keep things as is, you will not get any signal. So you got a couple choices.
Yeah.
You can get cable TV or satellite TV. Does that interest you at all?
No, not at the present time.
Not for you?
No, not right now. I don't need it.
All right. Well, you could buy four new TVs that would receive a signal.
Wait a minute. I don't want to. I have to buy four new TVs?
You don't have to if you don't want to. What we could do is we could get some converter boxes that we could attach to these TVs, and you can get a digital signal right away and make sure that you don't lose any signal come February. How's that sound?
Oh, that'd be nice.
Yeah? You interested in that?
Yeah, of course.
We'll get you all set up. We just need to get behind this TV and see what's going on, okay?
All right, great. All right.
Let's have a look at what you got here, Fran. Looks a little bit like my house. You know what? Despite all the wires here, it's a pretty typical setup. So this wire right here is coming from the roof antenna, and it is going into your VCR, and then it is coming out via this wire here and going to the back of your TV.
Right.
Now, you could have gone straight from the antenna to the television, but in this case, by going through the VCR, it allows the VCR to record anything that you see on the TV, and that's something a lot of people like and obviously something you will use. So all we have to do is interrupt this with a converter box. Mm-hmm. And let me show you what we are going to use. Here's how it comes to you. There are a couple of pieces. First, let me show you the box itself. That's not too bad, is it?
No.
Nice and small?
Yeah.
Very simple. It's got a power cord on the back, and then it has got some inputs and outputs right here. And what we are going to do, if you'll hold that, is we're going to set this right here, and we are going to take this cable that comes from the roof antenna, and we're going to feed it into this input connection right here for the converter box. Mm-hmm. Once that is in, we have to take the output and we have to come back into the VCR. And if we go back to the box right here, there are a couple sets of cables. Two of them, in fact. Now, some TVs use these types of cables. They're called RCAs. And they've got a whole bunch of different inputs and outputs. But a second option right here is this cable with a little pin in the middle. Mm-hmm. And actually, for our purposes, this is going to be the easiest. So we are going to go from converter box using this cable, let's push that in there for a nice fit, into your VCR right here. And believe it or not, that is almost all we have to do. Now we're just going to power this up, and then we're going to program your channels using the remote. All right, I've got the converter box plugged in, and now we've got to get this guy to scan all the channels you have available here. So let's turn this on. Frank, can you hand me that remote? Sure. This came with the converter box. It's got a little power button right here. Blue light tells us that the converter box is on. And now we have to turn your TV on. And we want to make sure that we go to channel 3 on your television. So let's get to channel 3. And you will see a welcome screen right here. And so what we're going to do is we are going to navigate through the menu using the remote that came with the converter box. We're going to choose all the questions that it asks us, English, regular aspect ratio. And now it is scanning to see what channels you receive over the air, and it is telling that to the converter box. Now, if you received a good signal from that over-the-air antenna up on your roof before we came, you will probably continue to receive a good signal. If you don't, well, the first thing you want to do is make sure you've got everything connected properly, all plugged in, and it's working. And then, if you're still not receiving a good signal, you might have to rotate that antenna up on your roof, and you want to point it to where one of the broadcasting towers is, and you can go to the website to find out where those towers are. If that doesn't fix it and you are actually all connected properly, well, then you might want to call a television antenna technician and they can help you out. So here it says it is finished. It found 25 channels. We are picking the time zone. It actually gives you the right time and date. And thank you. Setup is complete. So now we should have a better picture and more channels. What do you think of that picture?
That's great. All right. Great.
Yeah. Now, wow. You actually get more channels because with DTV, we are multicasting. So, for example, the local PBS station is 44, but now you get 44.1, 44.2, 44.3, and even 44.4. So a lot more channels are going to come to this television set thanks to the converter box. All right? Yeah. So this is all set. You said you had three more in the house?
Yes, sir.
Well, we can get those fixed up for you as well.
Sounds great.
Want to show me where they are?
I certainly will. I'd be happy to.
Now, this house has a satellite dish, and I see no signs of an over-the-air antenna, so this should be easy.
Hi, Dom.
Hi,
how
Karen.
Are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Now, I noticed you have a satellite dish up on your roof. And look at this TV. I mean, a big, nice, widescreen TV. So that must be hooked up to the satellite dish.
Yes.
So you have digital TV and high definition. So you really don't have to do anything come February 17th.
Yes.
Must be great watching movies and sports.
But I do have another TV.
You do?
Yes. Okay. This way.
Oh, over in your kitchen here, you have a small TV on the counter. But this one's not digital. You're working off of this little antenna.
Yes.
And so come February 17th, this is not going to work. You know, you're going to have to do something.
Yes.
Now you have a few choices. You could run another cable from your satellite dish to this TV.
I don't want any more wires.
Okay, so you don't want to have them drill holes or anything like
that. Yes. No.
Okay, your second choice would be to buy a converter box. They're not very large. It would sit on top of the TV, and then you set the antenna on top of that.
What other choices do I have?
You could get a new TV with a built-in digital tuner. Does that appeal to you?
Oh, that's good.
And you like this size?
Yes.
I think I got just the right thing for you.
Thank you.
Okay, Kiang, I want you to hold on to the antenna. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to try to use that again. And out with the old TV and in with the new one. What do you think of this?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, well, wait till you see the picture. Now, this is an LCD TV with a built-in digital tuner. Now, when people start looking for new TVs, they have to do a lot of research before they go out to buy it. They come in all different sizes with all kinds of features. They run from several hundred dollars to several thousands of dollars. This is on the low end of the spectrum, but it's going to look great. Let's see if we can get it hooked up.
Okay.
Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is plug your old antenna into the antenna input. It just slides right on. All right, now I have to plug the power cord into the back of the TV and then into an outlet. And we're ready to go. Okay, Kiang, we've scanned for all the channels that are available in your area and they're locked into the TV. Now, because the broadcasters are still broadcasting in analog and digital, we can make a comparison. You're looking at an analog signal right here. Now, if I go to the same channel in digital, you'll see it's quite different. See that?
Why? So clear.
Yeah, nice and clear and crisp.
Yes.
Well, you're all ready for digital TV.
Thank you, Norm.
All right, you're welcome. My pleasure.
Bye.
So here's a house that doesn't seem to have any equipment on the roof, no satellite, no antenna, but there are some wires coming from a telephone pole here on the street, and those wires come over to the house, and one of them drops down right here. And this looks like a coax connection. So my suspicion is that this house is receiving its TV via a cable wire. But of course, the homeowners will know for sure, so we should check with them to find out. Hey there, Rebecca. Good to see you again.
Hi, Kevin. Good to see you, too.
So it looks like from the wires on the outside of your house that you guys might have cable TV.
Yes, we do. We do have a digital cable.
Digital cable. All right. So where's the TV?
It's in our family room.
Oh. Wow, that is a big, beautiful TV. And I can see the cable wire coming in out of the wall right there, okay. So now you say digital cable. Now the reality is whether you have digital cable or analog cable, you're not gonna be affected. So long as you receive your television signal via a cable wire, this TV is gonna continue to work.
Now, it's possible that your cable company is doing an upgrade and they're going to want you to change out your cable box, but that's completely unrelated to this government-mandated change to digital TV. The reality is that this TV works now, and it's going to continue to work in February, so you're in good shape.
That's great.
Yeah.
But I do have another TV upstairs,
okay.
which is a lot older.
We can take a look at it.
Here is the other TV up in the bedroom.
All right, let's have a look at what you've got here. So it's definitely an older TV. This is an analog standard definition as opposed to the digital high definition that you have downstairs. But it is hooked up to cable, so that means that this TV is just fine now and will be in February. Old analog TVs like this hooked up to cable are not a problem. So your whole house is DTV ready.
That's great.
Hey, John.
Hi, Norm. Good to see you.
How you doing?
I'm doing just fine.
Let's see what you have for TVs here.
This is an old analog set that we have tied into an antenna up on the roof. Mm-hmm. We've had it for some time, and I've also got a newer one that I have down in my office space.
Okay, but this is just standard definition.
That's
Let's
right.
take a look at the one in the
okay.
office first.
And this is my other TV down here in the office, which is also hooked up to the antenna up in the attic.
Okay, a nice flat screen TV, an LCD display. So it should have a built-in digital tuner. But to be sure, it'd be nice to take a look at the owner's manual. Do you happen to have it around?
I do keep that stuff in with my manuals.
Okay.
Yeah, here it is.
All right. So what we want to do is we want to find the specifications page. Here it is. And we want to look at the TV standard. It says TV standard ATSC. That's great news. It means it does have a built-in digital tuner and it's high definition. So you don't have to do anything with this TV. But the old TV upstairs, we're going to have to do something with that one.
Oh, okay.
Now up here in your old analog TV, you're going to have to install one of these, a digital converter. And this has a feature called analog pass-through. And that's important for some people because they will be able to receive low power analog signal. It also allows you to continue to receive high power analog signals until February 17, 2009.
That's great.
And you know, it's not too bad to install.
No, I think I can handle that. Thanks,
All right.
Norm. I
All
really
right.
appreciate you coming out.
My pleasure. Well, Maria, we have good news. Most people are in great shape.
And just a few people needed a little bit of help, but we got them squared away.
Well, that's great, but it's just a start. Remember, there are 22 million homes out there that are going to be impacted. That's 40 million television sets that are going to be affected. So remember, seems complicated once you get the information, not so complicated after all. Most important thing is that cutoff date, February 17th, 2009. Take care of it before then, you'll be fine.
All right, thank you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this special program on the conversion to digital television. Thank you for watching.